Hey everyone, Paul Bowden here from the Microsoft Office for Mac team, here out of Building 36 in Redmond, Washington, the home of office engineering. Each week, we aim to bring you, the deployment insiders, the best practices, tips, and tricks for managing and deploying Office 365 Pro Plus. Today, I'm going to talk to you about the differences between downloading Office from Microsoft's CDN versus Apple's Mac App Store, and the pros and cons of why you would want to do one over the other. You'll find the end user functionality is largely identical between those two methods of deployment, but there are definitely some gotchas that IT admins should be aware of. Okay, first of all, let's get some terminology out of the way. The traditional way of downloading Office is to go to microsoft.com or products.office.com and find a forward link that allows you to download the package directly from Microsoft. This is known as Microsoft's CDN or Content Delivery Network. In January 2019, we added another option, and that is where you could download Office apps from Apple's Mac App Store, or colloquially known as MAS, M-A-S, to most Mac admins. So that means you have two ways to acquire Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneNote, and OneDrive for your users. So why did we add the Mac App Store as an alternative option? Well, for consumers, people like my mom, the App Store is this trusted front and center place where she can get all of the apps that she needs on her Mac. So this gives her a single way to acquire and update all of her apps, which really gives her this like nice friction-free experience. But what about enterprises? Well, Apple provides various programs like volume purchasing through Apple Business Manager or Apple School Manager that you as an IT admin can use to acquire or purchase apps, and then use this managed distribution technique to distribute those apps to all of your users. So the key question becomes, should you just dump the old CDN method and push all your deployments through the Mac App Store instead? Well, as you might expect, the answer is, well, it depends. So first off, let's do some comparisons. Most, but not all of the Office apps are available through the Mac App Store. Notably, Teams and Skype for Business are only available for download directly from Microsoft CDN. Maybe surprisingly, there are very few differences between the Mac App Store version of Office and the Office that you get from the CDN. For Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook, the only visual difference is what happens when you click the Get Add-ins button. For Mac App Store builds, you see a browser window pop up. For CDN builds, you get this in-app experience. So it's not really too different. OneNote is identical between those two versions. And then lastly, with OneDrive, there's slightly more functionality that you'll get from the CDN version of Office rather than the Mac App Store. Namely, in the CDN version, if you go into Finder and then look at the OneDrive folder, you'll see what we call these file overlays, those little green status icons next to your files and folders. So what about security? You may have heard that Apple has very strict requirements about the sandboxing and sealing of apps when they're available through the Mac App Store. Well, the good news is that regardless of how you get Office, we adhere to those same security and sandboxing guidelines. So you don't have to make a trade-off between the performance, functionality, and security of the apps. It's all the same. What about enterprise management then and MDM control? Well, more good news there. There's actually no difference between the two. Even with a Mac App Store version of Office, you can use those same preferences and policies that you normally would. Okay, so it's almost sounding too good to be true. Let's go over some gotchas that may not be obvious. The first is licensing. With the Mac App Store apps, you can only use Office 365 subscriptions. When you download the apps from the Mac App Store, you don't actually pay for them to just download them. What happens is you download them for free, and then when you run them up for the first time, they'll ask you for activation. Now, if you're a consumer, you can choose to either perform an in-app purchase for a new Office 365 subscription, or you can simply enter existing credentials if you already have a subscription. Now, for businesses, your users are going to have Pro Plus, A3, A5, E3, E5 licenses, and they'll be signing on with their Azure AD credentials. So the one big exception here is if you've purchased Office 2019 volume licenses. Those are one-off perpetual licenses, and you cannot use that type of license with the Mac App Store builds. Instead, you must get Office directly from Microsoft. The second gotcha is the Insider program. So you may remember from our other videos that we have channels like Insider Fast and Insider Slow. Well, those channels and that functionality is only available when you get the builds directly from Microsoft. When you get the builds from the Mac App Store, you're essentially getting a monthly production build. It is the best experience that we have to offer, but you cannot join an Insider program with those builds. The third gotcha is around how updates are delivered. With the Mac App Store, all the updates come through the Mac App Store client app, which is on the user's computer. Whereas you may remember that when you download Office directly from Microsoft in the CDN, we supply a program called MAU, or Microsoft Auto Update. And that is the app that is responsible for keeping you up to date. So MAU doesn't get used in the Mac App Store approach. That's actually not a bad thing, because the Mac App Store itself provides you with updates to macOS and also first-party apps from Apple like Safari and iTunes. And some larger enterprises may have even set up some dedicated content caching servers so that users get a really fast experience for both the initial install of a Mac App Store app and also for getting an update. And because Office comes through that same Mac App Store channel, you can piggyback off of those content caching servers and still provide users that great experience. If you're in an environment where your corporate users have their own Apple IDs and you don't have strict version requirements for Office, using the Mac App Store for acquisition is a highly attractive approach, and it's something I'd absolutely recommend. On the other hand, if you're using managed distribution and you have strict version control requirements over the exact build of Office that's running on each of your users' Macs, the Mac App Store is probably not the right approach for you, and you're likely to want to stick with Microsoft Auto Update and get in your apps directly from Microsoft. You can only install the version of Office that's present in the Mac App Store today. So if today is production release day, and we've just gone live with a brand new build of Office, and you want to install Office on a new user's machine, you can only install that new version of Office. You can't install an older version of Office. Now, for existing users that already have that older version of Office, well, you can defer updates for several days if you wish. Secondly, updates are all or nothing. When you're using managed distribution, you're using an enterprise manageability tool to essentially push updates. And in the UI for those tools, you'll probably see a button which says force update or something similar where you can actually initiate the update. However, you can't just scope that force update to a segment of your users. It's all or nothing. When you hit that button, all of the users that are enrolled in that MDM server will get the signal to perform the update immediately. However, when the Macs in your fleet receive that update signal, the conditions have to be somewhat perfect for the update to complete. Of course, the app is going to be on the machine, but the app needs to be in a closed state. If your users are used to leaving their apps open, things like Outlook or OneDrive, what will happen is that the signal will get received, but because the process is in a launch state, the update will silently fail. And through managed distribution, the App Store client, which usually gives users notifications, isn't actually involved in the transaction, so the user won't actually see any notifications that will tell them to close the app or tell them to go get the update. Now, of course, you can click that force update button multiple times, perhaps waiting a few hours in between, but that's still not going to guarantee that those users have closed those apps. And because this is MDM, you can't actually run a policy to close those apps on behalf of the users. You may be thinking about the command line tools that Apple provides, like software update, where you can SSH into a computer and remotely run the software update command. Well, that sounds like a good option. The problem there is that software update only works for the macOS itself and for first-party Apple apps like iTunes and Safari. Third-party App Store apps like Office don't get controlled through software update. Okay, so perhaps you're thinking, well, what if the user just opens the App Store app? Can't they just go and get the updates themselves? Well, that doesn't work because if you've pushed the app through an MDM channel, then the App Store client doesn't get involved and it doesn't understand that that transaction has taken place. So if the user were to open the App Store app, well, first of all, they would need to have an Apple ID to be able to log on to the App Store, and then they'll see Office, but if they click on those download buttons, it'll simply overwrite the existing version that you have on their machines. So it'll achieve the goal, but essentially users will now have their own version of Office installed rather than the corporate version of Office. So there you go. Those are the main considerations for choosing between getting Office from the Mac App Store versus the CDN. As you can tell, the Mac App Store is really a great experience for consumers and for scenarios such as bring your own device, where users have more control over the software that's running on their machines and they have their own Apple ID where they acquire the software. If, on the other hand, users don't have Apple IDs and you have strict version control requirements, you're likely to want to stick with the CDN method. I hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please click the thumbs up button below and hit the subscribe button if you want to receive notifications of new content in the future. If you have questions, you can find me in the Microsoft Office channel on the MacAdmin Slack forum. Take care, and I'll see you next time.